Remember Bruce Lee said, breaking bricks is fine, but bricks don't hit back. Now we can make the brick hit back. I'm very impressed. I think there's lots of opportunities here to drill these sorts of scenarios. It's really changing the game in terms of training. It seems to be a step in the right direction. This is probably the closest I've seen to being able to simulate that to a reasonably high degree of fidelity and drill your teamwork, drill your complication management skills. What we were trying to simulate was an uncontrolled rupture, a situation whereby we've partially opened the Sylvian fissure, but the aneurysm has bled. We don't have proximal control. We don't have access to the M1. I was the volunteer surgeon in this scenario. So the first thing that happens is your field gets full of blood. And we dealt with that by placing a suction on, not trying to tamponade the aneurysm or put things in the Sylvian fissure to tamponade the bleeding. Trying to suck the bleeding actively, clear it, see where it's coming from. And once I can see the hole, this simulation was maybe closest to a very heavily atherosclerotic aneurysm, because what I expected to happen was the aneurysm would collapse and then I could put a big fundal clip on it. But in fact, it didn't collapse. So that gave me another problem I had to work on. And it was analogous to an atherosclerotic dome. We got a bigger clip, we moved it down further. We still had some trouble. I put a clip on what I thought was the M1. It turned out to be the M2. But the simulator made me think, well, why is it still bleeding after I've clipped the M1? Could there be backflow through the M2s? Which is the sort of process one goes through in reality to understand why you haven't trapped the aneurysm. And then ultimately we were able to get a clip on the M1 and just finish off the fundal clipping to have control of the situation. And from there, we can go on and clip the aneurysm in a controlled fashion. But this was all about dealing with uncontrolled bleeding and also just allowing the candidates hopefully to experience, it's very important not to panic. And that as long as there is blood coming out of the blood vessel, there's also blood passing through the blood vessels to the brain, delivering oxygen, the nerve cells are viable. The situation is not lost as long as you stay calm and work the problem systematically. Collapse the aneurysm down as much as you can and get yourself back into a controlled situation where you can then design the best clipping.
So you want to assist with your angle, your point of view, you don't want to block access to the lesion, to the main surgeon, and producing kind of serious, dramatic environment at the time of surgery, and the bleeding itself was something pretty impressive. It's not just a short leakage, it's just a real bleeding, like in real surgery. So you have this kind of induced stress and stress response assisting you. It was not just about performing well, but trying to manage the fear associated with potential complications.
It's an opportunity to debrief on the teamwork during it, scrub nurse, the assistant, the surgeon, and then think about what the surgeon felt you could have been more assistance. There were certain things you could have done. We can run the scenario again and try it that way. And maybe it wouldn't work as well as the surgeon thinks it would, or maybe it would work even better. And then we drill the team to deal with this situation. I know from real world experience that having an experienced team used to working together in these situations makes them a lot easier to deal with. So I think this is a tremendous application. I would like to use it again, please. Can we go again?